welcome to the most beginner-friendly web development course. Before you get started, you should know that this course was specially designed for absolute beginners with no programming experience or for those who are struggling to understand the various concepts of web development. Also, I'll be posting a video or two every day for the next few weeks. Each video comes with a special gift, a nicely designed cheat sheet, and maybe some other resources. Please subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss any of the lessons or the gifts. The link for the cheat sheets will always be in the description box, as well as the other resources that I'll be providing. Finally, I answer promptly to comments, so feel free if you have any question or any comment at all. Let's get started. Alright, so I'm going to give you a brief tour through the projects that we'll be looking at in this course. Alright, so before that, this is the cheat sheet I was talking about, alright? Nicely designed. I designed them myself, and I'll be giving you one for every lesson. Now, this will be our first project. This is an HTML and CSS website, very responsive. It has only 3 pages, but they are all, nicely designed. Some basic stuff over here. And next, we'll look at this JavaScript project. This is a calculator. It has the functionalities of any basic calculator at all. Alright. And then next is this very simple encryption decryption project. It's one of my favorites. It's very simple, but it's a very good project to practice your JavaScript. And then finally, we look at this website over here. This is done using Bootstrap. Let me open it up a bit. Or let me close it this way. Alright, so this is designed with Bootstrap, right? Bootstrap makes things very easy, very, very responsive and nice, alright? And finally, we'll be adding back-end functionality to this website using Firebase, alright? We'll add some user registration, we'll add some, other back-end stuff, alright, to this very website over here using Firebase. Alright, so let's get into it and let me show you what we are going to be covering in this course. Okay, so in this course, we are going to be looking at web development. Web development is broken into 2 main parts. We have the front end and then we have the back end. Okay, so front end is everything you see when you go onto a website, everything you see there. Back end is basically the database where data is stored. So for example, when you go to Facebook, or everything you see, you click the design, everything is front end and the interaction. And then when you upload your file, say your picture, it has to be stored somewhere and it has to be managed. When you need it, it has to be brought back onto the page, and that is done by back end. Okay, so those who focus on developing front end, are called front end developers, and those who focus on back end are called back end developers. So in front end, we have a number of languages: HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and we'll be covering all those languages in this course. So let me quickly summarize for you what each of these languages does. HTML is what gives you the content of a website, the markup. So if you visit a website, the text you see, the images you see, everything that you see are provided by HTML. And then CSS is what gives the beauty to the website. It adds the styles, okay? So the colors, the shapes, and the nice margins, the rounded borders, and all that is done by CSS. So they work hand in hand. And JavaScript is what gives life to a website or a web application. Okay, so JavaScript gives you interactivity. For example, when you click, something happens, right? When you go to a website, then you click. Okay, see, it says click to download. So when you click, then it does a download for you. Or when you click, something shows, a dialog box opens when you click. Or it's a game. For a game, for example, when you click, something moves somewhere. This is all done by JavaScript. So JavaScript is the main programming language behind web apps. So every web application out there definitely has some JavaScript, has some HTML and then some CSS as well. And we'll be looking at all these languages. So I mentioned web application, and I've also mentioned websites somewhere along. So websites and web application, what is the difference? Websites are static. So when you take a blog, for example, you just go to the blog and you read and you see things. You don't really have a lot of interaction over there. But web applications have interactions. They are just like apps. So Facebook, for example, is a web application. You don't just go and see stuff. You can upload stuff. You can chat. You can do all those things. But you, of course, you can't do that on, say, an NGO's website or a blog, right? So that makes Facebook, for example, a web application. Or Twitter is also a web application, right? So those are the front-end languages we'll be looking at. Now, we'll also look at what we call a library. A library is a special set of code, okay, pre-written code. So some developers look at the way we do some things and they try to make it simple. That's all about programming. Once you become a master, you also try to make things easier for other programmers and even yourself. So they write a bunch of code. Let's say, for example, I'm going to create a website, okay? I need to create a navigation bar or a title bar or something like that, okay, or a menu bar. Now, normally you'd have to go through the bits of HTML, you write the CSS, then you add the JavaScript yourself. But some people say that, oh, why don't we just make it simple for people so that with just a few lines of code, they can get the header there. So that's where libraries come in. Bootstrap is a very, very popular library, and it was created by the Twitter development team. So it's one very popular library, a library of HTML and CSS. That means it makes coding in HTML and CSS very simple. So for example, if I'm going to create a menu bar, instead of writing the HTML from scratch, CSS from scratch, or if I want to change the color of something, it makes all that easy. Okay. So look at Bootstrap later on. But before you can use a library, you have to understand the language that is behind the library. Okay. Bootstrap is, as I said, a CSS library. It means that before you can properly use Bootstrap, you have to know CSS. So once you master Bootstrap, you won't be using a lot of CSS. But to be able to manipulate the Bootstrap codes to fit or do what you want, you have to understand the CSS. That's why we need to take this part very important. Finally, backend. As I mentioned earlier, when you talk about backend, you are talking about database, okay? You are talking about storage, where you store the content of a web application or a website. The common way of creating backend or creating databases is using languages like PHP and sometimes Python. But in this course of ours, we are going to be focusing on front-end development. But we will still need to do back-end, okay? If you want to create an actual web app, if you just want to create a website, you can do that with even just HTML and CSS. But if you want to create a web application, you have to add JavaScript and you need back-end. And some people being so smart, they make back-end simple for front-end developers. So if you're a front-end developer and you want to do back-end, you want to create a database to store your users' data, you actually don't need to use a language to go and learn a language like PHP all over again. You can use Firebase. Firebase is a service created by Google. Google created this. It was actually created by a company earlier, and then Google took it up and then developed it. So it's now owned and run by Firebase, and it works amazing. You get to host and create databases and all sorts of stuff for free. Talking about free, I'll also be teaching you in this course how to host or upload your website to the internet for free and have it worldwide. And there's a way of actually doing it for free. Of course, if you want to upgrade, you want to go to higher levels, you need to pay some amounts here and there, but there's a way to actually do it for free, and I'll show you. Okay, so we'll be looking at PWAs as a bonus in this course, okay? Progressive web apps are amazing. They are taking over. A progressive web app is simply a website or a web application that is downloadable just like mobile apps. So a web application that works like mobile apps. Mobile apps can be downloaded and mobile apps work offline. So that's the key feature of progressive web apps. They are functional offline, which makes them just like mobile application, okay? So they are very fast and they are secure and all that. So these are just some reasons why people like to use web application. But in my opinion, the most important reason why web apps are taking over is that, you know, when you are creating an application, first, usually people start with the web application. So they create a web application. So you hire web developers to create a web application. Then you hire Android developers to create Android application. You hire iOS developers to also create the iOS application and so on. So it becomes a lot. You have to have different teams managing all these apps and you have to pay them and all that. But if you have a progressive web app, it's just one app, okay, that works on Android, that works on iOS, and works on the web at the same time. So Twitter currently is using a web application. The Twitter app that you find when you go online currently is a progressive web app, and then you can actually download it and it will come to your desktop as an icon without going to the app store. Alright. Okay, so that's a quick summary of everything we are going to be doing in this course. There might be a few other things that I probably haven't mentioned. As we go along, you mention them, and I want to reassure you that programming is not beyond you. You don't need to be a master mathematician to do programming. You come across a lot of obstacles, but don't let that break you. Push through it, and then you can definitely become a senior developer someday. Thank you, and see you in the next lesson.